Like if he makes a giant Edwin and conceals it. So I need to have Sylvanas Shield Slam to take the Edwin. If I go for this game plan. It's only got one Cold Blood. And then Prep Eviscerate too? Or is he just putting the damage in now? It's unfortunate for me that he got that spare part. It's gonna make it harder to stay alive. Just added 6 damage to his deck, man. He's got Leroy Cold Blood Eviscerate. So he's got lethal. Not anymore. Alright, we're just barely alive.
Thank you.
Got one more execute activator in the deck. Kinda wanted to save that minion for Brawl, but we only have one Brawl anyway. So it's the same chance as finding Sylvanas, you know? That's a good card. Back up to 30 life. That Roman numerals thing was kind of funny. Replacement for Geddon? You could probably just put a second Brawl in if you got a second Brawl. So right now I only got one Brawl in. Alright, we need Sylvanas or Brawl here. Otherwise we're dead to this giant Edwin. That's kinda how the matchup goes. Is he gonna conceal it? It's only a 6-6. He's not doing this, right? He's supposed to wait until he has his whole deck and then make like a 30-30 and conceal it. But this is no problem for me to kill. He should win this matchup most of the time, but especially with the Blood Thistle Toxin spare part, it's just so much damage. But it's a really tough matchup for Rogue to play correctly, but if they play it correctly, they're like super, super favorite. It's just Warrior's inability to correctly deal with Conceal. Everybody playing Rogue. Everyone's playing Face Shaman. Rogue's a really bad matchup for my deck. But I was expecting not very much Rogue because of all the Face Shamans and Face Warriors. Prior to switching to Anti-Aggro Control Warrior, I only versed Face Warrior and like the Face Pirate Warrior and Face Shaman. So again, we're going to try and kill every single minion that this guy plays for the entire game. So, we're going to begin that process by making sure we armor up All the time. All day, every day. All armor, all the time. Just thinking about Koinasaing my face. Whoa. Next turn, I want to play War Axe and Doomsayer. Kill his 3 drop, drop the Doomsayer. Not getting into that opportunity.
This guy's a toast.
He's got conceal in his hand, or cold blood. An interesting conceal. 8 damage conceal is not very big in this matchup, so curious. Usually you want to be getting like 10 damage out of your conceals. I got 8's pretty close.
So many options.
I just got trade into Armorsmith. We might be able to win this, I guess. And conceal it out of the way. People are really good at playing around Harrison today. Yeah, I need to show block. Alright, he should dagger up here. Let me get a good Harrison. He'll poke face, but at least we'll get a card. Barengeddon worth crafting? If you want to play Warrior, Barengeddon's one of the best cards for it. Like 10 cards in my deck to kill this. Who the fuck just YOLOs that out there? really frustrating.
I have no time for games.
Brotherhood shall prevail.
Remember, man, I still have Harrison. Just float 2 mana, don't dagger.
I got the best deals anywhere.
Just YOLO gadgets again, because he knows I don't have an answer in my hand. Punished. The fuck is this guy doing?
Pay attention, class.
I'm ready to learn.
He's got no gadgets left. An Ezra Drake, an SI, and an Earthen Ring. 3 minions. That's it? Yeah. 3 minions, Cold Blood Eviscerate. 2 minions, Cold Blood Eviscerate. Thalnos, 4 minions. Oh, the Zeril's in his deck too, okay. There's a lot of 4 drops. Teacher, Zeril. Maybe no Earthen Ring then. SI7, Thalnos, and maybe Earthen Ring left. Deadly poison? What is this? The Earthen Ring SI. After these two are gone, there is just Blood Mage Thalnos left. If I can kill both of these and avoid a Cold Blood Conceal turn, then I should win. Doesn't even Cold Blood. He needs to be hitting with those while he plays them, otherwise he's not gonna have enough damage in his deck to kill me, so. Brendan, man. The way to win against Warrior is you don't snipe and YOLO your Auctioneers and they don't have the removal, because it's not that great unless you have the hand for it. You have to be super patient, wait for your resources to line up, get the gadget conceal, go off with all the spells, find your entire combo, make a big Van Cleef, conceal your big Van Cleef, then Leroy, Cold Blood, Eviscerate, and then get the big Van Cleef in. Or if you don't get the big Van Cleef in time, you gotta have a minion stick, double Cold Blood, hit me in the face with it, then conceal it. Otherwise you run out of damage like this. He even had Conceal Spare Part, that's the best one. One ghoul left.
Get back.
This is a very favorable matchup for you, man. Prep Cold Blood Concede. Somebody's triggered, man. This is the second person that Q-sniped me with Rogue in a row. Second person got smashed. People are really bad at Rogue. I didn't even draw Justicar that game. Same guy? No, that's a different guy. Two different guys, legend rogue players at rank 15, sniping me with golden rogue. In a favorable matchup for rogue. And then just losing. It's like the most blatant snipe ever, too. YOLO gadgets because he knows I don't have a way to kill it in my hand. And I top deck a way to kill it and just punish him. And he loses. Yeah, if the guy didn't snipe, I think he had a better chance. He just made like really, really poor decisions. Do I also smoke normal cigarettes? And what's your opinion on smoky on stream in general? Yeah, I used to. And I would take breaks or like hide my camera to do it. Coin Wild Growth, usually you have a follow-up, so it's just Doomsayer's follow-up. And then when I switched over to vaping, I always used to hide my screen when I vaped, but didn't want to like influence people or anything like that, but I don't know, everyone kind of just told me nobody really cares, so just do it on stream, it's fine.
strike.
That's a good top deck, actually. It's not many that we had in our deck, it was like that and Bloodhoof Braves. Brawl Doomsayer combo.
Caress your fear.
There you guys, Mark of the Wild from Raven Knight. Maybe it'll go off. You never know. Dude, he just YOLOs the Drake and top decks it like a god. Shit. Not yet an answer. Nice. Damn. We're close. The end was almost here. Four tens are big.
Where shall I start?
Here comes C'Thun. Two executes, 15 cards. Fuck yeah.
Sure.
Ancient One calls. I have an axe.
The fuck? What is that? Starfall me. I wasn't even from Raven Idol. He's just running Starfall, man.
I have no time for games.
Just try and not die. Back to 7, man. Druids and rogues. probably Zoo, right?
Your soul shall be mine. Let the hunt begin.
Kill him, man. Get him, Firebat. That's my boy, right to the face. Twelve life already, dude. His opening was so aggressive. So aggressive. We got a double Call of the Wild. Yeah, we're dead. We need them explosive traps bad, man. Should have probably traded that. I was just believing in the knife at that point. Should have tagged the weapon first, but I get one less hound, dude. I hit explosive to stop his lethal. Explosive? Never explosive. What's the winning play? Skill command quick shot. Be defensive. He gets 2, 3, 4, 5 though, so 2 damage kills us. And then there's Houndmaster face. And if he taps, still misses lethal. We could have double kill command. I know we need kill command quick shot to kill him. That's how we win sometimes. I think it's the only way. We really need an explosive trap there. Then we can play explosive trap, shoot, hide the tiger. Next turn, punch him for 10, kill him. Well, 17. Is it even possible to make Hunter good against Zoo? It might just not be able to be done. Unless they go way too deep. They also have camels in there, which makes things awkward. Four drops suck. Four drops are all just depressingly bad. Thank you. I don't know if we're even gonna win the board early. You have to win the board early for this to work. This seems really bad. What about Gormok? I don't know. All right. Worst deck 2016? Did we win the award? PogChamp? We got like 10 cards to cost one.
The light protects me.
Fuck yourself. Come on, man. Never lucky. And Earthshock? All of my tempo I just generated just destroyed. One fellow swoop. Guys, I got it. If it was around, I could just abuse it and still be winning. That's unfortunate. Hmm. Losing board. Not good. Trying to play Zoo Hunter, man. We don't have comeback mechanisms for this. We're just trying to curve on people. I don't think most people are gonna have Flame Juggler, Juggler, Earth Shock perfectly. Hit one drop. Man, he kept three cards. Uh-oh. I don't like when they keep three cards, man. I'm just trying to make Hybrid Hunter. Close. Now he upgrades his weapon trades here. We on the hunt that Houndmaster the guy? The problem with this is he has Arcanite Reaper and I don't. My blade be thirsty. Who's that for an adventure. Need Abusive Sergeant or Quick Shot or Kill Command. Not huge toad, man. I think we have to go face if we want to win. Every other play we lose over two turns. So here's to hoping.
What now?
Yeah. This idea is not good. I do need Golden Paladin, you guys alright? Maybe I should play Murloc Paladin. Do I even own the one drop guy? I might not. Yeah. The problem with trying to play Murloc Paladin, I don't own that guy. I could play regular Murloc Paladin. Do I want Lay on Hands? I feel like I really want Sylve. Just because Sylve is good. Not a lot of room in this deck. Tyrion's like really important against Warrior, right? So I can't really cut Tyrion. We can't beat Shaman if we don't have weapon removal. Probably don't even need two bluegills, right? I don't know. Lowers the consistency of finding one bluegill, which is important.